Hello and welcome to Broadcast Basics. I'm going to give you a quick overview on what producing is and what it takes to plan a news report. And then I'll share a couple of interviewing techniques that I like to use along with other journalists. The first step is choosing your story. And really the question you want to ask yourself is, what is news, right? Just because a story is interesting to you does not necessarily mean that it's newsworthy. So I have a list of a few questions that you can ask yourself when you come across something that piques your curiosity and you want to dive deeper into. First, ask yourself, is it timely? The story should be something that's new, that hasn't happened before, or is relevant to current events and what's going on in the world. Is it useful? Is there information in your story that the audience needs? Is there something they can take away from it? Is there something, an action that they can do after they hear your story? This can apply to news like the weather, traffic reports, maybe even a segment about a local election coming up. These are things that are useful information for your audience and helps them make better decisions in their life. Also ask yourself, is it impactful? The story can't be interesting to just one person for it to be newsworthy. So ask yourself, does it affect many people? Is it of interest to many people? How wide of an audience do you have for this information that you want to share? Does it have proximity? Again, you want to think about your audience. Is this something that's happening near them, or is it something that isn't really relevant to their daily lives? You wouldn't tell a story about something happening in a local city in Australia to people who live in Michigan, unless there's a way that you can connect it and it has proximity and impact on their life. You can also ask yourself, is it prominent? Sometimes the stories that travel the fastest and are shared the most are the ones that involve important people, places, or things. For example, a story about a celebrity or a politician is usually going to get shared a lot more quickly because everyone knows who that person is. The same with a story about something that happens in a popular city like New York or Los Angeles, London, Paris, because everyone has familiarity with those cities, it's probably going to be of interest to them. You can ask yourself, is there conflict? And this can be a debate or it can be an obstacle. It doesn't necessarily have to be conflict between two people, although that can be interesting. But it can also be something that the subject of your story has overcome, a challenge that was really hard and they found their way through it. And finally, you want to ask yourself, is it unusual? Is this something that you hear about every day, or is it something that's a little out there? This makes something, your story, really interesting to your audience because it's something that they don't hear about every day. The important thing to remember when you're asking yourself these questions is that your story doesn't have to hit all seven, but it should hit most of the things on this list to be newsworthy. If you find that your story is timely, it's something that's new and just happened, but it's not really useful and doesn't impact that many people, then it's probably not newsworthy. For example, if you find something that is unusual and maybe even has conflict, but it doesn't involve anyone prominent and it's not impactful, it doesn't matter to a lot of people, again, it may not be newsworthy. So this is supposed to serve more as a guideline for picking the story that you want to tell. So here we have four different stories that count as newsworthy and are good examples of what you would consider to be newsworthy. In the Hartsville Messenger, there's a headline that asks football season, and it's essentially about whether or not the local high school there will have a football season this fall because of the pandemic. That's something that's new and newsworthy, and actually it's new because it's asking a question that hasn't been answered yet. It's also relevant to something going on. The pandemic is affecting people across the country, so it is something that will be relevant and of interest to your audience. The Buffalo News says that a $50 million film and TV production complex is coming to the west side of Buffalo, New York. that's something that has proximity, because I'm sure a lot of the people who live on the west side of the city will be impacted by this and will want to know more about it. And it has useful information, because people are probably curious about whether or not this will affect the economy, if there'll be more jobs, less jobs, and just how it'll affect their community overall. This one's a little interesting. The headline says deer on the attack. This story is about how deer in this particular city have been attacking dogs lately. And so that's something that, even though it's unusual, it's also newsworthy because it's impacting people in that area, most of all dog owners who probably want to make sure that their loved pets are not at risk. It's something that's timely because it's currently happening. And then for the blade, this is an example of prominence. Four councilmen in Toledo are facing charges of bribery. These are four public figures that people in the city know pretty well. So this is something that they're going to be interested in and is most likely why it made the front page. So now it's time to plan how you're going to do your report. I'll walk you quickly through the first steps. First, you want to research the facts. You need to figure out, is this a new story that you're interested in, or is there already information available on it? Maybe your audience already knows about it, so you won't waste time going through the basics. Or maybe someone has already reported on it, and you want to make sure that your story is adding to that and introducing new information. Then you need to figure out when your deadline is. If your story airs at 6 p.m. that evening, you want to work backwards from that time and figure out how long it will take you to see it through from beginning to end. And that way you can decide what to spend, what to prioritize and spend more time doing, and what are some steps that maybe may not be as important. In news, it's super, super, super incredibly important not to miss your deadline. Nobody wants to have a black hole in their newscast, right? So most people, this is probably one of the most important tips, because you want to make sure that even if you have a good story, people get to see it. And then it's time to schedule your interviews. Ask yourself, who are the important voices in this story? Who is someone who knows the most about it? Who's someone who maybe experienced it, and what can they add to what it is that you have to say? Decide on whether or not you have a visual story. Is there something in it that will capture your audience's attention? It could be good information, but you want something that will make your audience sit down in front of their TV, their computer screen, or their phone, and watch everything that your report has to share. And then finally, create a backup plan to your backup plan. It sounds silly, but honestly, being prepared is one of the best things you can do for yourself. Especially in the news industry, things do not go as planned. Sometimes the person you're interviewing could show up late, or your camera could run out of battery, or maybe you forget your pen and your notepad at home. So it's important to always think of a plan B and plan C before you even head out the door, so that way you can be set up for success. So now it's time to figure out who you need to talk to. And before you do that, there are six questions that a lot of journalists like to use whenever they're first starting out, and it kind of helps them figure out what direction to go in. I call it the 5 W's and 1 H. It doesn't really roll off the tongue, but they are questions that you are probably familiar with. Who, what, when, where, why, and how. These are questions you want to ask yourself when you're trying to figure out the most important part of your stories. Who's involved? What happened? When and where did it happen? Why is it happening? And how did it happen? It helps you get down to the details that really matter. And then you have to figure out who it is you want to talk to. So one of the questions you should ask yourself is, who's the expert here? Is there a public figure, a politician, maybe someone of authority who can talk about the subject that you want to share? Maybe it could be a scientist, a researcher, a professor. And then think outside of the box, because most times the people you would consider to be an expert may not be the most interesting voices. Sometimes when you talk to the person who was there when something happened, or who may know insider information that other people aren't aware of, that gets you an even better story. And sometimes it gets you a scoop over the competition. A lot of people talk about talking to the custodian when you're there reporting at the school. That might be somebody that you may not consider interviewing, but that could be somebody who has the most interesting information to share. And then you need to contact them. And it seems like common sense, but a lot of people hope that interviews work out without actually taking the steps to make sure it happens. So reach out to your person. The phone, I think, is most effective, but you can also email them. Be professional and use social media as your last resort. And then research them. A lot of times people show up to interviews unprepared. They don't really realize who it is they're talking to, and for that reason, they may not ask the best questions. If you were doing an interview with Beyonce, you wouldn't ask her what she does for a career, right? So make sure you know who it is you're talking to and you have that background information ready to go. And finally, prepare your questions. This is not something you want to wing. You want to walk out of that door knowing exactly what information you need to bring back to tell your story. And so the best way to do that is to prepare your questions ahead of time. I usually suggest, depending on how long the interview is, doing 5 to 7. You may not get through all of them, but at least it gives you a guideline once you're there. And ask them in an order that helps make the interview easier. So I usually start off with something more simple. What's your name? What do you do? What happened? And then I get into the tougher questions that require more details. Finally, it's time to do the interview. There are two types of questions that you can ask in an interview. One is close-ended, the other is open-ended. I'll walk you through what a close-ended questions are and what open-ended questions are, and I'll explain to you why one is more effective than the other. Close-ended questions are questions like, do you like your job? Is it hard? Will you do it for a long time? We call these close-ended because you can't really give much of an answer here, right? It's either yes, no, or maybe. This doesn't really make for the most effective report because it's not really interesting, and also it's not adding information to the story you're trying to tell. So focus on open-ended questions. A different way to ask those same questions are, what do you like about your job? What are your biggest challenges? How long do you see yourself doing this? These are more effective, and if you'll notice, they use the 5 W's and the 1 H. What and how? This gives your story more color. It gives the person you're interviewing a chance to really expand on what they want to say, to include emotion and feeling. There's just a lot more interesting details you can get from asking your questions this way. Now I want to walk you through a couple of my favorite interview techniques. These are techniques that a lot of professional journalists use to take their interview from being one that's just good to great. One thing I focus on a lot is making it conversational. I think interviews can be really tense and nerve-wracking situations, not just for you, but for the subject that you're trying to talk to. So it helps to put them at ease, making it feel more like a conversation and less like an interrogation, maybe, can help you get better answers and just make for a better experience for everyone involved. Make sure you're actively listening. A lot of times you might walk into an interview with a story already in mind, but if you're listening, you may get a gem or two from your subject's answers that help you realize there's actually a better story there to tell. And then it helps you adjust your questions accordingly. This might seem counterintuitive, but silence is actually really powerful when you're doing an interview. Sometimes when I ask a question, after my subject is done answering, I'll just take a pause, only for a few seconds, nothing weird, but I find that pause makes them continue talking, and sometimes I get even more information than I realized I could with that silence. Then don't be afraid to repeat your questions. If you don't get an answer that is helpful or good, or maybe you know your subject stumbled while they were answering it, it's okay to ask them to do it again. So it can be as simple as saying, like, do you mind repeating that? Or you can ask the question again in a different way to get a better answer. And finally, don't hesitate to ask for more sources. If you're talking to someone who's relevant to the story, chances are they know other people who are just as relevant too. And it helps you add more voices to your story that are important and help make it even more newsworthy. So ask them for suggestions. And finally, one of the most important things I like to remind people about is to fact check your story. Just because you got an interview does not mean that it's necessarily factual. So you want to make sure that all the information you're including is based in truth. Just because your subject says the sky is blue doesn't mean that you report that without checking for yourself. So make sure that you do your research, you have your information to back it up, and that if you're going to include an opinion in your story, that you make sure that your audience is aware that that's what it is. In today's era of news, that can be very important. Thank you.